What is going on, everyone? Crazy Man, bringing you guys a gameplay commentary today. This game's not so much about the gameplay, although whoa. So today we got a 3v3 on the map Boreanaz Refinery. We have a Redbeard spawning his Chaos Force. We have Codex playing a 3v3, which he normally doesn't do, and then we have myself playing as the War Boss. And today we have everyone's favorite, well, second favorite, Calzy4. Playing in my lane is the mech. We have Max Power playing as the Force Commander. We have Field Marshal Yark playing as the Farseer. So, yeah, this is a 3v3. Not so much about the gameplay, though. I will make a few comments and tips and tricks, but I want to start making strategy videos. Probably not this weekend, but next weekend, definitely, I'm going to start making some strategy videos. So, it should be interesting to see how those pan out, how I do in those. If you got any games or you're wondering how you lost or why you lost, be sure to send them to me. And I'll go ahead and cast them. Try to help you guys out, but why have I been producing a lack of videos? Well, number one, I've been uploading on my secondary channel. If you guys haven't, go subscribe. I'm seriously saying go subscribe. I'm actually partnered over there with Viso Network, or V-I-S-O, Viso. And that's really cool. So that's a thing. And looking like Codex may lose his Force Commander here. Oh, no, oh, oh, nicely done there, actually, to force back the Banshees a little bit, but Slugger Boy is going to finish the cap. And look at the, one of the things I was questioning is his retreating. He was retreating quite often in this game. My computer's lagging for some reason. Let's do some weird camera stuff to see if we can fix it. Oh, yep, I fixed it. So anyway, I know, really weird, right, how I do that stuff? But, yeah, yesterday we went out to the beach, a whole bunch of people. I think, like, that ended up being about 15 people throughout most of the day. And, that was a good time. Played a lot of volleyball, and I got some... Boy, I got burned. Like, I don't mean burned in volleyball. I was actually doing really good in volleyball. I mean burned, like sunburn. All over my shoulders, all over my back. It's really bad, so. I'll be streaming, though. I do a lot of streaming. That's just why... That actually leads me to my next thing I've been hearing a lot of is, why don't you do live comms anymore? I don't do live comms because those are the things you kind of have to prepare for. And a lot of the times I just get invited to private lobbies and I join. I don't have time to set up a, you know, to sit here and set up a YouTube video. I just join and I play. And then if it's a really good game like we got the other day, then I'll go ahead and cast it. This one's not a very good game. By any standard, so don't think, oh boy, he's uploading this just because, you know, there's a reason I'm uploading this and you guys will see why in the later part of the game. But, damn, I'm not sure what's going on with this lag. It's really weird. But yeah, I do a lot of streaming now, which is live comming, except it's live. And I like that because of the fact that I can answer questions right then and there. You know, I can, you know, if you guys have questions about what I'm doing, anything like that, I can just be like, turn around, bam. Right there. So the link to that will be in the description. If you click the follow button, you'll get an email each time. I'm sorry about my European viewers. I usually stream pretty late at night on the US East, so unless you, like, alter your sleep schedule, which I would not recommend doing, it's probably not going to be too beneficial for you. But unfortunately, there's not a lot I can do. I can't really stream during the day because I got work, although this next upcoming week, I'm going to have plenty of time to stream during the day and plenty of time to stream, so if you guys want to go follow me there. Plenty of live comms. Plenty of live comms. Assault Marines getting out with just one model there. Codex calling it close. Cutting it close, rather. And I build my favorite orc unit, arguably my favorite unit, the Pain Boy. He's so good. I mean, just watch this heals. This heal I throw on him. Watch this. Toss it. Heal on the War Boss, and look at it. Look at it go. It's nuts. So he goes for double knob shooter. Single knob shooter, rather. And I don't like getting the knobs on the shooter boys. Unless you're going up against, like, the Chaos Sorcerer with his dual worship. Or units that can infiltrate right away. And obviously, me playing the war boss, I'm not gonna do very much infiltrating anytime soon. I mean, unless they... That's just some sort of mod. I just like infiltrate, and then it doesn't understand. Also, another tip I want to give you guys in this video: when you're gen bashing, take out the node. What I like to do a lot is hit one node or hit one generator, take that down, and then hit the node. That allows me to take out a generator, which is 100 rec, and I lose my pain boy there, which is a big blow, but you get doubled. And that's gonna happen. Probably should have got out of there a lot earlier, but got kinda greedy. I think I killed off his Sluggas though, so pain boy for Sluggas, obviously a nice trade in his favor, but... See, this is why you would wanna probably do something like that. But anyway, we've got tech advantage, so... It's all good. What else is there? Oh, people wondering why I didn't play in the 1v1 tournament, why I may not play in the next one. They don't allow random, and I know people are going to say, oh, get over it. The thing is, when you play random for as long as I have, you don't even know which race you're really good with. I'd like to think I'm pretty good with the war boss, but, hell, I don't know. I think I'm pretty good with guard, too, but they're just not a 1v1 race. I mean, they can win 1v1s. Don't sit here and... I'm not going to sit here and be like, oh, that's impossible. What a 1v1 would be fairly high-level play. Because it is possible. It's just unnecessarily tougher than what it needs to be. You need to get a lot of breaks. You need to kill off a lot of... Just... Things need to fall... The cards need to fall in the right place for you. That's what needs to happen for the guardsmen to win a 1v1. Whereas with other races, they can just... do certain strategies that win the game and have certain builds that are naturally more successful for them. But regardless, very fortunate about that Force Commander special attack right there, as I think he probably would have killed my war boss. But I already talked about the 1v1, so I don't know, I may try it out. I didn't participate in the last one because I was assuming I would be gone. Turned out I didn't actually end up going anywhere, so that was kind of a disappointment. But, you know, that's whatever. I wasn't really too bothered by it. Had a good time watching. And, he goes ahead and tries to throw up a custom force field. He's also got the death gun, which is an interesting choice. Mainly because he hasn't really had his commander with his army. And now with this Death Dread being out on the field, it's not really going to help him out much at all. So you can see he's calling for help, and max power just immediately implies no. The reason that Max really can't give a lot of help here in this situation is because there's two of us down here. And there's gen farms. The thing about this map is there's gen farms in two areas. There's a northern gen farm and a southern gen farm. You've got a decision to make, and you can't just leave your gen farm. So he comes down here, and they end up triple teaming down here. Which in turn is going to cost them their northern gen farm. It's just the way things are. Look at this. Blood Crusher just charging into base. No fear. He actually hits you with a Melta Bomb. Which, yes, he does. And going back to hitting the gens. Now notice the devs are actually facing this northern position here. This is to have them, not sure what that was. To deter any sort of Death Dread attack. And I actually saw that. I don't remember when I saw it in-game. But I definitely saw when it had showed up. And when it was facing there. And at that, actually, when I was running over here, and then I decided to gen bash, I believe that's when I had saw that his, devs were facing that northern position, so that's a good play. But overall, those are two very solid gen bashes. We were able to take out a gen here, we were able to take out two gens and a node here. P-Dev nearly smoking all those shooter boys. And the Power Claw is up on the War Boss. Tried to use Angry Bits to actually position myself behind the cliff, but it didn't quite work out that way. So, time to call a full retreat. No shame in that. Been applying pressure from this area, in this specific area of the map, for quite some time. So that's a thing. But yeah, I've been pretty busy with a lot of things. Like I said, I stream at night, so if you guys absolutely have to get your fix, I've been uploading every day on my other channel as well. I'm almost done with... I shouldn't say I'm almost done with Company Heroes. I'm about halfway done with Company Heroes 2, the Let's Play. And here I just kind of sacrificed my Death Dread. I mean, I know that's going to sound stupid, but there's really no purpose for it. He's got a lot of AV. He's got a Death Dread of his own. Not to mention it was a double team. So if you guys haven't noticed, I'm emphasizing the double teams here, because when you get doubled, that usually means you just want to get out. You don't want to do what I'm doing and hang around. But, taking out a Derpdar gate. And so here he's firing his barrage. Good idea in essence. Actually does work out fairly effectively, but a P-Dev knocking back his own units. As that's rather unfortunate. For him at least. You can see trying to position the Slugga boys around the cliff. They don't make it there in time, but Warboss doing what the Warboss does. Try throwing out a warp vomit there, just a little bit late, but regardless, map control in the north is ours once again. In this southern battle. Get going here. You can see the damage these Havocs are taking. Good grief. But the Chaos Dreadnought's getting awfully close. And Farsa's got her Singing Spear, she's got her Rune Armor, and she's got her Spirit Stones. Brainlance positioned way back there. But, this is where things get rather interesting, so you may want to bump it up to 720. I apologize, I can't upload in 1080, but those videos too big. No comment needed here. And you will see... Oh, look at that. That's unfortunate. I think he's gonna kill him, though. Should get... Oh. Oh, that's really unfortunate. As, hopefully you're still watching in 720. Is that C right there? That was not a drop. He done it again. So, that's the game. Figured I'd just, this is actually kind of a long update video, but I figured I'd just throw some gameplay on and I'd give you guys a quick update what I've been doing. As, Yark is apparently Santa. Announcing right here, we have it confirmed. But I hope you guys enjoyed this game. My live streams, I do tips. I play music. Some people don't like the music, but that's fine. You can turn it down. I do that to kind of just relax. Listening to music puts you in the zone, puts you in the mood, but anyway, I don't want this video to go on too long, longer than what it needs to, so I'm out. Peace!